Καλησπέρα σας, καλοί φίλοι τηλεθεατές. Good evening. Before I go further, just let me say a big thank you to our sponsor, Dr. Vasilis Mavrou and Varos Lettings. Thank you very much, Dr. Mavros. And I'm going to welcome a beautiful lady. Her name is Irini, but for short is Rina Louise. Yes?
Yes, yeah. Thank you.
Good evening.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Yeah, busy working, but I'm good. How are you?
I'm okay. Now, looking at you, you look like your mother. I mean, yeah, you took it from your mother and might be from your papu. You know,
yes.
I don't know your yaya, but you know, I know your mother and your papu. Yeah, you look like mother and papu.
I'm okay? Very lucky.
Yes. So, you are very busy at the moment, yes, doing quite a few things. I mean, recording songs and at the same time you rehearsing for a pantomime and all this, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
So,
just before we go further, because we mentioned Papu and Yaya, your mom is Greek, okay?
Yeah.
So, give me a little bit more information about your family. I mean, and you born in London, I suppose?
Yeah, so I was born in London, and my mum is Greek, and my dad's Jamaican, so I'm half Greek, half Jamaican. And
good combination. Very good combination. Yes.
Thank you.
That's okay.
I grew up with my yaya mostly when we was younger, when my mum was working and stuff like that. So I'd stay at my yaya's house 3-4 times a week, really, and she'd look after us. I used to call her Mummy Yaya because...
Yes. You put it together, yeah.
Yeah. So she was like my mum. And then obviously I kind of have both sides, Greek and Jamaican, but I'm very proud to be Greek. There's not many people like me around which have a Caribbean side and a Cypriot side, so I'm so proud to have my Caribbean side, but to be Greek for sure. And my yaya and papu and mum really kind of installed that in me.
Yeah.
I love like all the food and stuff. That's like my favorite type of food because all my yaya used to feed me. But yeah, I wish I did learn more Greek. I was kind of rebellious as a child. And I was like, I don't want to learn it. But now I try and teach myself Greek to kind of, you know, when I have kids, I want to teach my kids to speak Greek because I think that's really important to know their background and culture.
Well, it's never too late, you know what I mean? I mean, some people, they start learning languages when they're 60, 70.
You know what I mean? So I try and teach
myself. It's never too late. So... You study performing arts?
Yeah, so I studied at Italia Conti for 3 years. But before that, my mum opened up a performing arts school called Platinum Performing Arts.
Yeah.
And that's been running for 15 years now. So I studied there all my life and got my experience from there. I started teaching at the age of 12, which was like ballet and tap. And then I started writing pantomimes at the age of 15. And I've been doing it ever since.
Did you?
Yeah.
So that's good. Plenty of talents, you know?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, can we just take the music at the moment, talk about your music, because you and your sister, you have your own group, yes?
Yes, yeah, we're the Lewis sisters. We've got our own group. We started that around 3 years ago now.
Okay, so you appear, in many places. You have your own songs recorded?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we've got there's only one song out at the moment called The Beat Goes, and we performed on The X Factor. That song was called The Beat Goes, and that was really, really good. That was exciting, and that featured Richard Blackwood, who's a famous DJ and comedian in the UK. Now we've got some loads of exciting bits coming. We've got over 250,000 followers on TikTok, which is amazing. We've got loads of fans.
That's very good, yes.
Yeah, and now we've got some new music coming out in November, December, and next year. So it's not out yet, but we've got loads of music to come. So
Do you write your own songs and music, or you have other people to write the music and lyrics for you?
So the first song that we brought out, that was all my writing. And then I'm always open to people to work with, really. Having your own kind of brain is amazing, but to have like different inputs is really amazing as well. So there's some tracks coming out with some amazing people who are in industry. And then again, within the future, I'd hopefully be working with big artists and big people who write. So yeah, it's half me and then half other people's input as well.
Yes, good. Good. So you mentioned it already. You write in pantomimes and all this. Where you get your subjects from? I mean, based on stories original stories or?
So the stories with the characters, I kind of have the characters in my head. So this year one is Cinderella and her lost prince. Uh-huh. So I know the story has to be about Cinderella, but then I like to be really creative. I've got a mind of a 7-year-old when it comes to colors and different ideas. And I absolutely love thinking outside the box. So I don't like anything to be normal. I like it to be crazy and for you to come and watch it and be like, wow, I never knew that story could be like that.
Yeah.
So the different subjects and ideas, it kind of just comes from just me getting excited by it. If I'm excited by it, then I know a child will be excited by it.
Exactly.
So yeah, I watch a lot of, I enjoy cartoons and I enjoy like silly, like funny things and videos. I kind of watch a lot of that because then that kind of, again, stimulates my childlike brain, I guess. I'm not saying that I'm not intelligent. I'm intelligent, but I kind of have that childish side and I've always kind of had that and I don't think that will ever go. So I think that's where I get my creativity from.
Uh-huh. So in this case, this year, you wrote the pantomime for Milford Theatre, yeah?
Yes. So we're doing the Milford Theatre panto and it's Cinderella and her lost prince. And I'll tell you a little bit about what it's about.
Yes, please, yes.
It's 15 years into the future now and she's been married to Prince Charming and she has two beautiful children and they're about to celebrate their 15th year anniversary. And then something goes wrong, really wrong. The prince gets stolen and basically the prince loses his shoe. You know how in the original story,
it's the opposite. Yes,
exactly. So then it's her.
So she has to find the shoe.
Exactly. Yeah. So she goes, she finds the shoe and she has instructions to go find him and she has superhero friends. So she meets her superhero friends and they journey to different kingdoms. We go to Candy Kingdom and the Animal Kingdom and they all these wonderful amazing places that don't exist, but I wish they existed. They go to the Prince Charming, and that's kind of the story.
That's good. That's good. That's very good. So, do you cast it yourself, or casting director? Yeah.
Yeah. So I also cast it. Obviously, we're working alongside Enfield Council and the Milford Theatre. Uh-huh. So we do obviously speak to them about it and go back and forth with them. But yeah, it's me and my mum, Nina, and also the choreographer, like our main choreographer called Tanya. She also helps us with that as well. I've got my hands in a lot of pies.
The music is written by someone else or?
So the music, so when we do songs, I would write the songs and then different music, we have like tracks that maybe like other musicians will make, but then we mix it together to make sure it's all original. But then we track you might know or young children might know, but then it gets mixed up. So then it's kind of an original and not anything that we've kind of taken.
Okay, that's beautiful. That's nice. So when is this going to be on? I mean, starting in December, when and how many, performances are you planning?
It starts December the 11th and ends on December the 31st. So we go all the way through the December period. And we have over 32 shows, if I'm not mistaken.
32 shows, yeah?
Yeah, 32 shows. So we have two show days, so one in the morning and one in the afternoon. And what's amazing is we've got loads of kids involved as well. Obviously, we have our school here, and we find it really important to give all the children the opportunity to audition for the pantomime. To get experience. I feel like when I was younger, yeah, if I didn't get that experience, then I would never be where I am at the age of 23. So yeah, so that, I think that's what's really amazing about it, is that the children get the opportunity from young as the age of 4, I think the youngest one we have in the panto.
Yes. So do you have any well-known, artists in, or?
So me and Kira, we're well-known.
You are known, yeah, definitely.
We have well-known people who are in the kind of community. So we have someone who teaches, the Prince, he teaches a lot of gym classes. So he's well-known in the community. He's doing it. We also have a lady called Lorraine who's playing the evil stepmother, and she's been in every single one of our pantos for the past 15 years.
Yeah, I might be sure because I've seen all the pantomimes at the.
Oh really? So you probably, yes. She always plays the evil part.
So a lot of
I'd say well-known people in the community, and that's what we like as well, is that in the community we are professional. We're as good as the West End. We just definitely.
I mean, I've seen so many pantomimes there, and obviously you are professional. I mean, you know, very good work, and you know, I'm always excited to watch a new show there as well, you know. So before we go to the song, I like to see a video clip, if you have one of your songs with your sister, with a group.
Yeah.
Louis Sisters, yeah?
Yeah.
Tell me about this song, which we're going to see in a minute.
So, is it just going to be a little clip of the song?
But the full song, we can play the full song.
Yeah, okay, so I'll give you, so this song is something that we did 3 years ago. And it's a special song for us because we didn't really know what we wanted to do as sisters. We knew we had something that we wanted to kind of show to the world, but we didn't know if it wanted to be music or presenting or whatever it was. And then sadly, our brother passed away. Our older brother, he's from my dad's side, he passed.
Sorry to hear that. Yeah.
No, it's okay. This happened around 3-4 years ago, and we said, this kind of shows us we have to stop standing around and waiting and contemplating about life, because it goes so quick. Let's do something. And then that's why we made this song, The Beat Goes. It's super upbeat, super fun. And that's what kind of led us to going on the X Factor and getting signed by Simon Cowell.
This is the one has been on X Factor as well, yes?
Yes, this one has been on X Factor.
That's good, that's good. Let's go and watch that and we come back, okay? Thank you.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
It's time to be schooled. Men are trash. Don't be
okay, real boss flow. Initiate hard body bars, let's go. Been a long time since I've been in the booth, so I brush away the cobwebs, it's time to get looser. Yeah, feel better, heat's gon' get ya if I sweat ya. Don't try and make yourself feel better. When I drop hard bars and I just dead ya. They feel nice. After 16 bars, I roll a dice. Feel wind in hands, I drop him nice. I bar my style, I think it twice like shit. I kill for fun, Tony Montana, Dom Gadon. I re-a-star, dropping ice, juking up rhythms, I am number one.
For the beat
of
your body, catch a slow wine. Drop to somebody, have a good time. On this night to end, don't pretend.
Okay, it's finished. It's all right. Doesn't matter.
All right. We are back now. Yes, a beautiful song, I should say.
Thank you.
Okay?
Thank you.
And thank you. So, just, you know, talking to your mother, you know, the other day, she told me that you are interested to write something, a play, based on a Greek community. And, you know, to be produced by me, if I can.
Yeah.
And, you know, cast it with actors from the Greek community as well. Do you have any idea? I mean, anything in mind?
I feel like with the Greek community, in my opinion, it's very loving, it's very family based, it's very, obviously I've got my cousins and my and the way we are, it's very, I'm very lucky to have them. I'm very lucky to have all my family, but I'm very lucky to have my and the way she's kind of grown me up.
Uh-huh.
And she's kind of taught me wrongs from rights, and there's a very, lot of comedic
very traditional, very traditional, yeah,
very traditional, and that's what makes it, that's what makes it funny, is that she's so traditional and she's so unapologetic that she's just her. So writing something about a traditional yaya in the UK with her grandchildren, whether they're mixed race and they have loads of Greek friends and stuff like that, and kind of fitting that lifestyle within the modern, and the yaya kind of getting used to the kind of modern times, and then the grandchildren understanding her side as well.
Yes. It's going to be very exciting, this.
Yes.
And you can have in mind that I can play Bapu as well.
Yes, so, yes, there we go.
Yes. So you can write the part for me as well.
Yes, if you're in for it, then I'll definitely write a part for you.
You know something? Honestly, I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah, yes. No, and what's quite good is that the traditional of the Cypriot side and the Greek side is that it's traditional, it's beautiful, it's the way it is, and it will never change. Like my Aya is stuck in her web, and that's the way it is. And then what's nice is that to show that loving side of acceptance, accepting what's different, and then also for the grandchildren and myself, what I've kind of been through is that I accept her, I accept the way she is, and it's beautiful and different. So that would be a beautiful thing to kind of show in it as well.
Lovely. And we can include some music as well, you know,
yes,
in it. Yes, which is going to be fantastic. Yes, honestly, yes. When you have a, you know, free time, you can start, you know, put your ideas down and we can work together. Because I'm writing too. I mean, I'm writing my plays, the ones I produce all the time. Usually I'm writing my plays, but I produce very known plays, sometimes translated to English, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But this one has to be in English, based in a Greek community, and with plenty of laughs.
Yes. Yeah,
looking forward to this. Yes.
Yeah.
Any other? Any other future plans? Do you have any other future plans?
So 2 weeks ago, I finished filming a short film, my second short film.
That's good.
Which is an amazing experience. It's called Power to Make a Change. With Platinum, we work alongside the MC Council. We got some funding. So we do that. And that premieres on November the 24th. So that's in a couple of weeks' time. So that's exciting. I've also got a child's book coming out, which be out the beginning of December, hopefully, fingers crossed if all goes well. And it's about a young girl who has curly hair like myself and kind of how she struggles and then how her mum teaches her that it's okay to be different and it's okay to look different and that you're beautiful and unique. Being unique is special.
That's so that's good.
Coming out this year. Obviously, we have amazing pantomime, which obviously I've written, but also direct and I'm also in it. So that's coming this year. And I also have a show in February, which is called Midnight Mystery, which is kind of like Midnight Murder. So it's kind of a murder mystery, which is really
Exciting. Yeah. A drama. It's a drama, that one, yeah?
Yes.
Are you going to produce and present it at the Milford Theatre?
Yeah, so many exciting things are going on in the Milford Theatre. We've got the pantomime, we've got karaoke nights, we've got comedy nights, we've got new shows, we've got Strictly Come Enfield, which is really exciting. So it's kind of like Strictly Come Dancing, but with all the Enfield community.
Yes.
So my Midnight Mystery will be February the 19th, and it's going to be a dinner and a drama. So you have dinner, you have starters, mains, and desserts, but you also get to watch a show as well.
Yeah, did you wrote this or it's a?
Yeah,
indeed.
I wrote it.
Bravo! And you wrote the short film as well, yes?
Yeah. So I wrote the short film. I wrote the book that's coming out, and I'm writing the murder mystery as well.
And did you direct as well?
Yeah. So with the short film, we brought in a team. So that I had a director, a producer, so on. I kind of creative direct because I know what my vision, I'm very particular on what I like to see.
Uh-huh.
And the director was absolutely amazing, but he let me have my creative say as well, which was amazing.
That's good. Okay, Rina, it's been a pleasure talking to you. And I'm very happy that you are very Greek, obviously. I mean, you are very Greek. Yeah, you do so many things and you love the traditions and you have your roots, and obviously you love Jamaica as well, and because you have Jamaican, yes, and I suppose you try both cuisines, Jamaican and Greek.
Yeah.
If I ask you which one you prefer, are you going to be in trouble or in difficulties?
No, I feel like I like both of them. I feel like when I was growing up, though, I had a lot more Greek. So that's why I'm going to say Greek. I love my Caribbean food, but my Ayaz food, unmatched.
Yes. Yeah, I suppose because she was, cooking all the time for you. That's why. Yes.
All the time. Every Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, we say that. And every Sunday, she'd make us macaroni de funno or kebabias or kefirs or whatever she'd make us.
Yes,
and
we'd
make every Sunday.
Yes, all these beautiful, traditional food. Yeah. Very good. So before we go, just give us more information about the pantomime. How can anyone, book tickets or how they can find out more information? Do you have a website?
Yeah, we have a website and we also have an Instagram that you can follow.
Okay.
So if you follow at Platinum Performing Arts or if you follow at the Milford Theatre, you can see all of our shows on there. Or if you go to our website, which is www.milfordtheatre.co.uk, you can find all the tickets on there also. As I said, it's from December the 11th to December the 31st. So it's an amazing Christmas pantomime with loads of laughter and fun and cheers and booze, with amazing actors and young students and people, which will be amazing. We also have a college here. So we have our school, but we have a Platinum Academy, which has been open for years, which is a level 4 diploma. So half of our college students are performing in that as well to put on their CV. So everyone is involved. So everyone come down and see the pantomime.
That's nice.
As I said, it's Cinderella and the Lost Prince. So even if you type that up on the internet, you'll find us and you'll be able to book loads of tickets. Bring your families, your mums, your dads, your uncles, your dogs, your cats, everyone.
How can I get a couple of complimentary tickets to come and see you?
If you message me, I can get you some complimentary.
Okay. Yeah, I like to come and see the. I like to come and see it at the beginning, so I can maybe write something, because I'm writing in a newspaper as well, or I can mention on the radio, you know. Okay, so thank you very much again, and I wish you all the best with everything you do.
Thank you so much.
Before we go, can you give us information about the clip we're going to watch in a minute and close with that?
Yeah.
Which is...
Okay.
Which clip you're going to let us, you know, watch?
Okay, so the clip that you're about to see is kind of our past work, which we've done with our different pantomimes. We like a twist of traditional and modern, and we put that together so the adults can enjoy it and also the children can enjoy it, the music they like to listen to, the costumes they like to listen to, the humor that adults and children also like. So it's kind of a mixture of everything and what we've been doing over the past couple years with all our different amazing actors and actresses and people we work with. So yeah, I hope you enjoy.
Lovely. Thank you very much again, Rina.
Have
a good night. Okay.
Thank you.
And I'm looking forward to see you soon at the Mifflin Theater.
Yes, thank you so much. I appreciate that.
All the best. All the best to you. Thank you. Before I go, I have to say a big thank you to our sponsor, Dr. Vasilis Mavrou and Varossi Lettings, that are supporting us all the way. And me and you, we're going to see each other again very soon. I'm sure about that.
Yeah.
And have a good night.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Shine so bright, and I can make right now.